Hi everybody, this is Indira, Assistant Professor of Institute of Aeronautical Engineering, Department of Mathematics. Today we are going to learn the last method of finding out the particular integral of higher order differential equations of module 4 in linear algebra and calculus. In this method, we all know that the differential equation is said to be non-homogeneous if it is in the form of f of t into y is equal to q of x. And if q of x is equal to 0, there is no need to find out the particular integral. So now if q of x is not equal to 0, we need to find out the particular integral to find out the general solution also. Here the q of x is in the form of e power x into v of x, where v of x can be sin ax or cos ax, or sometimes it may be x to the power of n also, or x to the power of k, where k or n is a constant. So let us see how to find out the particular integral in this case. We all know that formula to find out the particular integral for the higher order differential equation, that is f of t into y is equal to q of x, can be framed as 1 by f of d into q of x. Here, q of x is e power ax into vx. So the particular integral is 1 by f of d into e power ax into vx. Now, we can shift this exponential to the left-hand side by substituting d as d plus a. So, if you substitute d by d plus a, so this 1 by f of d takes the form of 1 by f of d plus a into v of x, and which can be further solved by the type of v of x that we have got it. That is, if v of x is sin ax or cos ax, replace d square by minus a square and you can proceed further. Or if v of x is in the form of x to the power of n, then take the aid of the binomial expansion and you can follow the binomial expansion for negative indices and you can move further. So that is the procedure for finding out the particular integral in this combined, that is when q of x is a product of two different functions. So let me repeat once again. In the last classes, we have seen the particular integral when q of x is equal to e power ax alone. In the second case, we have seen when q of x is equal to sin ax or cos ax. In the third case, we have seen when q of x is equal to x to the power of n. The first case is exponential, second one is trigonometrical, and third one is nothing but the binomial expansions. Now, if this is the fourth case in higher order differential equations where q of x is a product of two different functions, where the functions are already there in the above three cases. And in this case, we have e power ax into v of x, where v of x can be sin ax or cos ax or x to the power of n. Now, in this case, what we have to do, the exponential that is there as a product have to be shifted from right hand side to the left hand side by replacing d is equal to d plus a. If d is replaced by d plus a, then the character of e power ax is completed and it will be continued till the end of the particular integral. So the rest, the value, the remaining value is 1 by f of d is converted to 1 by f of d plus a into v of x. And this can be solved, but the solution is based on the type of v of x that we have taken. Suppose if v of x is sin ax or cos ax, then replace d square by minus a square. If v of x is x to the power of k, then you have to bring the denominator f of d plus a to the numerator and take the aid of the binomial expansion for the negative indices and do the problem. So let us see this one problem based on this method. I brought the very first problem. Solve the higher order differential equation d cube minus 7d square plus 14d minus 8 into y is equal to e power x into cos 2x, e power x into cos 2x. We can see that the q of x is nothing but the product of two different functions, e power x into cos 2x. right? Okay. So before I have said that there are two parts to code the general solution of higher order differential equation, that is complementary function in the particular integral. Complementary function can be obtained by framing the auxiliary equation. The auxiliary equation for this question is f of m is equal to 0, that is m cube minus 7 m square plus 14 m minus 8 is equal to 0. Solve this, that is, so if you do the factorization, it takes the form of m minus 1 into m minus 2 into m minus 4 is equal to 0. So m takes 3 roots, that is 1, 2 and 4. We have seen that the given equation is the third order higher order differential equation. The solution also contains 3 different constants. So therefore the complementary function can be quoted as c1 e to the power of x plus c2 e to the power of 2x plus c3 e to the power of 4x. So the first part of the solution is completed. The second part, we need to find out the particular integral. So let us see the particular integral in this case. We all know the particular integral is given by 1 by f of d into q of x. So 1 by f of d, that is 1 by d cube minus 7d square minus 14d, plus 14d minus 8 into e power x into cos 2x. So wherever d is there, you substitute d plus 1. So if you substitute d plus 1, the exponential will from right side, it is moves to left side, and d plus 1 whole cube minus 7 into d plus 1 whole square plus 14 into d plus 1 minus 8 into cos 2x is the next step that we have to evaluate. Now expand this by taking a plus b whole cube and a plus b whole square, and if you write it, the denominator in the least form, it takes e power x into 1 by d cube minus 4d square plus 3d into cos 2x. Now d cube, we all know that now the q of x is nothing but cos 2x. So the next step, we need to substitute d square is equal to minus a square. Here a is nothing but the coefficient of cos 2x, that is nothing but 2. So we need to substitute 2. So let us see what we are going to get in the next step. So e power x into 1 by, I have substituted d square is equal to, d square is equal to minus 2 square. So here what you are going to get here, d into d square, I can write minus 4d square plus 3d. So wherever d square is there, you can write it as minus 4. So this becomes minus 4d minus minus plus 16. Okay, so 16 plus 3d. So write it in the least form. So we are going to get it as minus 4d plus 3d plus 16 into cos 2x. Now it is nothing but e power x into 1 by 16 minus d into cos 2x. Now the next step can be moved. Next step can be brought if and only if I have d square in the denominator, but I have only d in the denominator. So this, in order to get the square of to the denominator, we need to rationalize the denominator. So what is the rationalizing factor here? 16 plus d, because we have 16 minus d, multiply and divide with 16 plus d. So 16 plus d by 16 minus d, which is the term which is already there. So multiplying and divide by 16 plus d. In the denominator, it is in the form of a plus b into a minus b, which is nothing but a square minus b square. So 16 plus d by 256 minus d square, exponential we need to write, don't forget to write the exponential till the end of the solution. So into cos 2x, again you replace d square is equal to minus 2 square. So this takes a form of e power x into 16 plus d by 256 minus of minus 4, which is nothing but e power x 16 plus d into cos 2x. Of course, cos 2x will be there, right? Okay, so 16 plus d divided by 256 plus 4, which is nothing but 260. So into cos 2x, and this can be written as e power x by 260. So d, we all know that you multiply each and every term with cos 2x. So 16 into cos 2x, okay, cos 2x plus d, capital D stands for the derivative, d by dx of cos 2x. So what is the derivative of cos 2x? Which is nothing but minus 2 sine 2x. So e to the power of x by 260 into 16 cos 2x minus minus 2 cos minus 2 sin 2x. So you can take this 2 as common and cancel with the denominator. So it takes a least form. Let's see what you are going to get here. That is e power x by 2 16 into 16 cos 2x minus 2 sin 2x. And this can be written as 2 e power x if I take 2 as common. 2 e power x by 2 16 into 8 into cos 2x minus sin 2x. So it is nothing but 2 times it goes to 1 and to 130. That is nothing but e power x by 130 into 8 cos 2x minus sin 2x is a particular integral. And this has to be added with a complementary function, which is nothing but c1 e power x plus c2 e power 2x plus c3 e power 4x plus e power x by 130 into 8 cos 2x minus sin 2x is a general solution for the given differential equation. Whenever you have equation in this form, like I'll repeat once again the procedure of finding out the complementary particular integral when you have the q of x as a product of e power ax into v of x. Right. So we need to bring the e power x from right hand side to the left hand side by substituting d is equal to d plus a, where a is the coefficient of the exponential. So if you substitute d is equal to d plus a, the character of e plus ax is completed. The operation of exponential is completed there. Now, to the remaining, we need to proceed further. Okay, suppose if v of x, the other product, if it is sin ax or cos ax, replace d square by minus a square, if a d square is there. Otherwise, you can rationalize the given function and bring the d square to the denominator and substitute, and the numerator d acts like the derivative. Even like that also you can do it. And the other part, suppose if v of x is x to the power of n, that is x square or like function like, then we need to take the binomial expansion to get the rest of the solution. So that is how we can find out the particular integral for the product of the two functions in higher order differential equations. Thank you.
Like, share and subscribe. Hit the bell icon for more updates.